Alright, Utara Rasionovers, selamat pagi Rasionovers. Today I'm going to make a couple of menu. That is ayam ungkep, yellow chicken ungkep, and the remaining for the chicken ungkep water, I will make soto ayam. And then I will make a mushroom soup. It's oyster mushroom. So like this, the oyster mushroom. It's very delicious. You can saute, or you can put into pie, or you can just make into soup. It's very delicious. Nah, ini enak sekali ya. Ini namanya jamur jamur apa ya? Jamur tiram. Kalau kita jamur tiram warnanya putih Indonesia, we have oyster mushroom but white one. Nah, ini akan saya bikin sop. Karena enak dibikin sop. Kemudian yang ini untuk buat ayam ungkep. Nah, dari air ayam ungkepnya itu nanti bisa kita bikin soto ayam. Okay, now here I will put it back into refrigerator. Meanwhile, I already boil water. This is for chicken. Also that one for this is for mushroom. Nah ini, no it's not for mushroom. Ada, it's for mushroom. This is for chicken. So first of all, I'm going to boil my chicken first and then throw until, I mean, the blood, I want to remove the blood first. And then I will wash and then boil again. So the water, the soup, my soup water will be not so dirty. Jadi kita akan rebus dulu ayamnya sebentar aja untuk menghilangkan darah-darah ayamnya itu. Baru dicuci, sudah dicuci baru dijerang lagi di sini ya. Oke, supaya bening kuahnya, enggak kotor. Oke, so I already prepare chicken here. Saya sudah siapkan ayam. This is grillo or wings, chicken wings. Jadi ini akan saya bagi. We'll divide this chicken wings to make soup. And then to make chicken ungkep. Nah, bahan-bahan untuk ungkep ayam, simple. For ingredient of chicken ungkep, I have sugar, salt, gula, garam, this one coriander powder, bubuk ketumbar, jahe, not jahe, turmeric powder atau kunyit ya, ini merica bubuk, I have on the black pepper, because white pepper here is very expensive. Kemudian onion I have. You can use a shallot, but shallot expensive. Also bay leaf, atau daun salam ya. Kemudian garlic, I will use a powder one. So this one, saya akan pakai bubuk, bawang putih aja. Kemudian bubuk serai, so I have lemongrass powder. You can use fresh one, bisa pakai yang apa namanya yang seger ya, lebih bagus lagi. Okay, so here I already prepare water. So for chicken ungkep, don't make it too much water, karena ayamnya sendiri akan mengeluarkan air, because chicken will have water when you cook them, ketika masak ya. Okay, nah komposisi untuk garam, gula, dan sebagainya nanti kita lihat dulu ayamnya seberapa banyak, baru kita bisa prediksikan berapa banyak. Oke, okay, let's start. Oke, okay, kalau sudah sampai gini aja ya, udah already like this, then turn off. No need to make it longer, otherwise you will lose your chicken broth here. Nah, kalau sudah baru ini dibuang, kemudian baru kita jerangkan airnya itu ya. Jadi seperti itu. Nah, meanwhile for here, for chicken ungkep, already prepare here for the chicken. Ini udah oke okay ya. Sekarang kita tinggal tambahkan garam, gula dulu. No. First make for turmeric powder. Make sure don't put too much of turmeric powder, otherwise it will be not good. So around here, half teaspoon of turmeric powder, setengah sendok teh aja turmeric powdernya. Kemudian lemongrass powder, segini aja cukup ya, dikira-kira aja. You just have to make maybe around 1 teaspoon, terus 1 sendok teh peres ya. Kemudian kita kasih ketumbar, then we put turmeric powder, not turmeric, coriander powder, just a bit, half teaspoon also, setengah sendok teh bubuk ketumbar, kemudian garam, tadi gula sudah belum ya, gula belum, gula setengah sendok teh, sugar 1 teaspoon, kemudian garam, garam also 1 half teaspoon, udah nambah ya kalau misalnya kurang, kira-kira aja, so around, maybe around. Cukup lah 1 sendok teh, around 1 teaspoon, and then you put black pepper powder, also garlic powder, that's all. Kemudian baru diaduk, kemudian diaduk, and then you just have to boil. First, you use a biggest fire, then after already boiling, you may make it small your fire. Jadi pertama-tama untuk chicken ayam, ungkep ayam ini, kita jerang dulu. Kalau dia sudah mendidih, jerang dengan api besar ya. Kalau sudah mendidih, baru jerang dengan kecilkan apinya. Okay, here everybody put garlic powder. Jadi sudah saya masukkan bubuk bawang putih. Sekarang kita aduk. Ini dilihat ya, kalau misalnya kuningnya masih sedikit boleh ditambahkan, tapi jangan kebanyakan. I will put a bit of this turmeric because it's too small. Just pinch it. Seperempat aja ya, so quarter teaspoon. Jadi dia bagus warnanya, cantik kan? Okay, sekarang kita akan jerang. Now we are going to make it bigger. Nah itu udah mendidih ya, kita kecilkan apinya, jangan terlalu besar. Nah ini kita besarkan, jadi beda dengan untuk yang jamurnya. I already put also this black pepper powder, sudah saya masukkan ya, bubuk bawang, bubuk merica itemnya. Jadi kita aduk. Okay. Ready boiling like this. You turn the small fire. You turn your fire smaller. Kacau ya, bahasa Inggris saya gini. Okay. Nah, udah mendidih ya. Sekarang tinggal kita kecilkan. Udah gitu aja. Tunggu. Biarkan dia menyusut. Let it until this chicken water become small. Jadi jangan besar kan dia, nanti enggak masak. Cukup ini, enggak usah ditambah lagi airnya. Nah, meanwhile for oyster mushroom soup already like that. Now we put onion there. I put only half of onion. Jadi saya cuma kasih separuh aja dari ini ya. Nah, baru kita kasih garam. So, give 1 teaspoon sugar tuh. Kasih juga gula, tapi nanti ya. And also what else? And garlic powder. Jangan lupa kasih bawang putih bubuk. Here, just a bit of garlic. Not garlic. Bawang putih. Sugar. Sedikit aja gulanya, jangan banyak-banyak. Jadi bagi pengganti penyedap. So, substitute of chicken stock powder. Nah, sekarang kita kasih bawang, kita kasih apa namanya? What do you call this? Garlic powder. If you like, you can make it lots. Around 2 teaspoon, sekitar 2 sendok teh aja. Kemudian kita aduk. Then we stir. Okay, Okay, stir just like that. Udah kecilkan apinya. Kalau dia udah masak, if chicken already well cook, then you put onion, green onion, and also oyster mushroom. Kalau dia sudah masak, kemudian udah menyusut airnya, also when water already shrink a bit, like half, then put oyster mushroom. Kalau sudah menyusut separuh airnya baru, dan udah masak, catatan udah masak ayamnya, baru kita masukkan jamurnya, jamur tiramnya, kemudian baru kasih sahang. Then after that you can put black pepper powder or white pepper powder Indian, so the smells will be sustain. Wanginya akan, wangi dari mericanya itu akan kuat ya kalau diletakkan di akhir. Okay, I think we let it for a while. Kita biarkan aja dulu. Okay, now my cuisine all done. This is for oyster mushroom chicken, but I will not put oyster mushroom because not yet want to eat. I mean, there will be time for me to eat. So if I put now and I have to preheat again, it's not good. Jadi untuk jamurnya sendiri, jamur tiramnya nanti saya masukkan pas saya mau makan. Kalau enggak nanti panas ulang, panas ulang kan enggak enak. Okay, so I will let it cool for a while. It's already cool. Now it is the remaining soup from my ungkep chicken. Jadi dari sisa kuah dari ayam ungkepnya ya. Jadi ini bisa kita jadikan buat soto ayam. So this one we can use for chicken soto. You just have to put cabbage, green or spring onion, and what else? Tomato. And boil egg. Jadi ini kuahnya ini kan kita ambil semua ayamnya, because we take all the chicken, because I'm going to bake the chicken, not to fry, karena saya akan panggang ya ayamnya itu, enggak saya goreng, nanti nyiprat mana-mana, males. Nah yang ini kuahnya kita bisa kasih telur rebus, irisan kol, daun bawang, kemudian kasih tomat, udah gitu aja. So for a while let it cool, and then you can put, you can close and then put it into your refrigerator. Whenever you want to eat, you just have to preheat again and then add some vegetables. Jadi tinggal dipanaskan lagi kalau mau dipakai. Meanwhile, here for the chicken, from ungkep chicken, already put here. I'm going to make, to polish again with my shashlik homemade sauce that I made by myself when we made shashlik on Saturday before. Nah ini ayamnya ini akan saya oles lagi dengan bumbu ini, bumbu shashlik ya, bumbu polesan ayam waktu kita bikin shashlik pas hari Sabtu atau Minggu, lupa. Jadi nanti kita akan panggang di suhu yang tinggi, around 200 degrees Celsius, because this plastic special for baking is can resist for 200 degrees Celsius. Ini sampai 200 derajat Celsius, 200 until 220 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, I also want to grill to put into oven this. I will show you my own recipe. So this recipe is awesome because I already tried before but I didn't have time to make video. Nah ini jamur kencing, so some pinyon mushroom that we put in Sveta 4. Actually they have good quality somehow, so I bought this yesterday. Jadi kemarin saya belinya itu masih putih-putih ya, so still white when I still what still white skin when I bought, because I choose one by one. I already put in the refrigerator, now become brown, it's okay. So in Sveta 4, some peonies, vizier, means that fresh champignon, atau jamur kancing yang segar ya, 1 kilonya itu sekitar berapa ya? Ah, nggak sampai 100 rubel. So for 1 kilogram of champignon mushroom is in Sveta 4 around 94.90 ruble. Nggak sampai 100 ruble. Nah, ini kita belinya segini, nggak sampai 1 kilo ya. It's not 1 kilogram. So around 732 kilogram that we bought this one. Okay, so first of all, I want to wash that because see, look, dust. Somehow I don't want my cuisine become not good, so I want to wash with water, but not just cut like that, cause dirty. Ini kan kotor ya, pegang-pegang orang tangan, jadi kita harus cuci. Nah, untuk bumbunya sendiri, for mushroom I have gorchitsa. Here is mustard seed. Nah ya, lebih bagus yang kayak gini. Nanti rasanya itu seperti kacang. Because if you use just sauce, like I want to this one gorchitsa also, sistruskaya. But this is like this, not like this. Jadi dia nggak ada bijinya. Dia sudah halus. Very smooth here. I'm not going to use this one. I'm going to use this one because it's very delicious. Karena ini enak sekali loh campur ini. Jadi nanti yang ini garcisa or garcisa apa namanya zernista ya or mustard seed. I put also salt, paprika and chili pepper powder and also what else that I want to put. Jadi ini mustardnya saya kasih mustard, biji mustard, garam, kemudian cabai bubuk, paprika bubuk, apalagi yang enak. You can put also champignon stock powder, bisa kasih kaldu jamur bubuk atau kaldu ayam or chicken stock powder and cumin atau kumin. Jadi nanti dia wangi atau jintan ya. Oke. Dan jangan lupa merica hitam. And don't forget to put black pepper powder. Or you can use white pepper powder. Okay, let's start. So here I already clean. And then I already put with napkin. Poke like that. So not too much. What to say? Not too much water. And I'm going to put here. First. We have to cut it. Di pertama-tama kita akan potong dulu ya. So like this. When you wanna cut, just cut. You may cut like this. Cut into four or better to like to cut like this. Oh, what is this? Jadi seperti ini lebih bagus ya. Atau boleh potong empat, tapi saya nggak suka ya. Supaya lebih meresap. Nah, jadi seperti itu aja. Nah, sekarang kita akan start, kita mulai. Kita kasih mustard seed-nya, gorchitsa. This is it's like peanut, I like. So 2 tablespoon, I think enough. Kalau kebanyakan enggak enak. Kemudian kita kasih garlic. Can you see that? Nah. Kemudian kita kasih garlic powder. Then you can give garlic powder as much as you like. Sebanyak yang disuka ya. Saya suka banyak. And after that you give black pepper powder. Jadi bawang putih bubuk, merica, mustard seed, biji mustard. Cukupnya aja, as much as you like. This is paprika powder, bubuk paprika, ini ya. Oke, bubuk paprika sekitar 1 tablespoon, around 1 tablespoon. Also, what else? Chili flakes. Semua ada pedes-pedesnya ya. This is chili flakes. What else? Jinjang vacuum in a bit. May press like this. But not too much, tapi jangan terlalu banyak ya. Nah, kemudian kita kasih stock powder. You can use chicken stock powder or mushroom stock powder, kaldu bubuk. Oh, garamnya lupa ya. If you already use chicken stock powder for salt, you must you should use not too much. Kalau sudah pakai apa namanya chicken stock powder, garamnya dikurangin ya, jangan terlalu banyak. Nah. Oke. Okay. Oh, second I wash my hand. Don't forget to add also cooking oil. Otherwise your mushroom will be dry. It's not good. Cooking oil here only we have in Russia. Sunflower cooking oil, minyak bunga matahari. Ya, kira-kira aja 2 sendok makan, tablespoon. Oops. Okay, what else? And then salt. I forgot salt. Saya lupa garam. Dikit aja garamnya. Kira-kira aja ya. Ih, susah. Susah pakai yang kayak gini. Sea salt, just a bit. Tapi jangan terlalu banyak, dia nggak enak. Jadi ini makannya enak. Bisa dimakan pakai kentang tumbuk. You can eat this with mashed potato or rice. Then all you have to do, you just have rasanya itu seperti makan kacang ya, enak. Biji master itu. Nggak need sugar, nggak perlu gula. Nah sekarang tinggal kita cemplungin, plong-plong kayak gitu. Nah, ya, mushroom ini masukin ke sini sampai habis. This mushroom is common in Russia. Champignon, there also brown one, brown champignon, which much more delicious. Ada juga yang jamur kancing coklat ya, nah, itu lebih enak lagi. Kalau kita cuma masukin bulat-bulat, nanti dia nggak meresap. Nah, can you take this one? Oke, begitu seterusnya ya, sampai semuanya tercampur rata. You can also, if you like, if you have mushroom less, you can also put potato or other vegetable that you prefer. Jadi bisa, kalau misalnya jamurnya sedikit, bisa dicampur dengan sayuran lain atau kentang ya. Nah, karena jamur ini cepat masaknya, kentangnya agak dipotong, jangan tebal-tebal. Since mushroom, this mushroom is easy to cook faster. So whenever you want to put kartoska or potatoes there, you have to cut thin, not thick, but not too really thin. Yeah? You just have to cut into cube or whatever shape that you like. Now I'm going to bake this one. Sekarang saya akan panggang ini. Okay, I forgot to mention, if you already bake this too much, you cannot eat in 1 day or 3 days, put a half or what portion that you want into freezer. But of course after this cuisine already cook. Jadi kalau nggak habis ya, ini kan banyak. Nah ini bisa di freezer kan. Jadi tunggu sampai dia dingin, masukkan per porsi, put into plastic per portion, then put into your freezer, not refrigerator. You don't want to eat for couple weeks, not good. Into if you put into refrigerator, not good. If for 2 weeks, okay, will be full of fungus or mushroom. Jadi jangan sampai terlalu lama di kulkas. Kalau enggak di freezer ya, kalau di freezer kan bisa tahan lama. Okay. Now I'm going to bake this one. Don't forget to cut a bit here. Otherwise, it will be like a balloon and it's not good. It will explode. Jadi jangan sampai dia nggak ada udara. Jadi harus kita gunting sedikit pada lubang. Kalau nggak, dia menggelembung. Oke, okay. I already preheat my oven too. Sudah saya panaskan ovennya. Now after this, maybe I'm going to hang my clothes again because before it's heavy rain. So the weather like this, unpredictable. Jadi mungkin nanti saya akan jemur baju lagi ya. Tadi hujan deras, nah kemudian nggak berapa lama ada matahari lagi. Oke, see you. This is the result of my chicken here and my mushroom. Actually, my mushroom still lots of water, so I'm going to make it dry again. But soon here I'm going to take because the chicken already good. Karena apa namanya? Karena ayamnya udah okay ya, jadi nggak perlu di mungkin sebentar lagi. So just soon I'm going to take it out from oven. Okay. But for this one, mushroom soup, I will put mushroom later. Plus, I forgot to put, black pepper powder. Jadi jangan lupa ditaruh mericanya ya. Ini akan saya keringkan lagi, oke? Okay? Here, I've already packed for my husband lunch and for my lunch too. Ini ya, udah saya pack-packin. So it's easy for us just to put into a refrigerator. Whenever we need it, we just have to warm that. Jadi tinggal dimasukin di kulkas, kemudian pas waktu makan dipanasi. If you want to eat at home, you may take just portion that you want to eat and then warm into microwave or into a pan maybe. Jadi kalau makan di rumah, ambil porsi yang kita mau makan aja, kemudian dipanasi di microwave atau di pakai panci ya. Nah ini ayamnya. Jadi dari satu pack ayam bisa dibikin tiga macam sayuran ya, sayur apa namanya, sop jamur ayam meskipun sedikit itu, kemudian ayam panggang, kuahnya bisa dijadikan soto, kemudian ini champignon sebagai pelengkapnya. So from one pack of chicken, you can make three cuisine. For example, mushroom soup, and this one, and soto. Okay. Jadi add more for water. Saya sudah tambah lagi airnya. Kemudian kita kasih black pepper powder dan sedikit black pepper powder here. Okay, sekarang. Tinggal kita kasih tomato. We give tomato, so this is mushroom, oyster mushroom. If not for saute, you don't have to peel like this, or you may peel either way you may. Jadi boleh seperti ini atau boleh cemplungin aja. Nah sekarang tinggal dikasih tomat. Ya, nah jamurnya tuh kayak gini. So this one you can put back near a refrigerator and put into plastic. Okay, so here bisa di seperti ini kan ya. Nah, baru kalau sudah masak nanti kita kasih apa namanya daun bawang and then give spring onion. Jadi kalau gini semuanya dapat, keluarga besar dapat. You have big family, you can get oyster. Here, kalau kecil nggak usah. Jadi seperti ini. It's very delicious dan sehat. Jadi nggak usah pakai nasi juga bisa. So you don't have to eat rice. Only farm salt, so gitu. There is excess water, just make it like this. Nah. Tunggu sampai mendidih. Wait until it becomes
cook.
Cantik kali. Delicious. Kepala langsung aja dimasukkan karena kita mau makan. So here, spring onion. Di seperti ini. Potong-potong. You like you can put into small one. Kalau bumbu goreng lebih bagus lagi. We have our onion and it's good, but it don't help. And all you have to do, you just have to taste. Tinggal diicip aja. Jadi menyehatkan. Wah, it's very delicious. Enak sekali loh. Nah, sekarang saya tinggal prepare for my bowl. Tinggal siapkan tempatnya. Okay, I think that's all for today's recipe and menu of my cuisine for a couple days. Jadi sekian dulu untuk resep dan menu kita untuk beberapa hari ini. Oyster mushroom soup, it's very delicious. Chicken oyster mushroom soup. Ini sup jamur ayam, sup jamur tiram ayam. So this is very delicious. Jadi seperti ini ya, I'm going to eat now. Okay, I think that's all. Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, comment, and don't forget to press notification button so you never miss our update video. Jadi jangan lupa untuk berlangganan, kemudian di share, di like, di komen, dan ditekan tombol notifikasinya supaya kamu gak ketinggalan video-video kami selanjutnya. That's the Resin Lovers. Sampai jumpa lagi Resin Lovers. Paka-paka. Going to eat now. Seger sekali loh. Enak. Garlic. For one day usually it's good for our whole around 3 to 4 garlic for one day. 3 sampai 4 cumi putih. Try not to bite. You just have to gulp like that. Otherwise your teeth will be broken. But I prefer to bite. Otherwise I cannot eat this just like that. Jadi biasanya 3 sampai 4 cumi per hari ya. Jangan kelebihan, gak bagus untuk kesehatan. Nah, bagusnya itu langsung di, kalau dia kecil langsung ditelan aja ya. Diminumkan dengan air, karena kalau digigit dia apa namanya gak bagus untuk gigi, rusak nanti. So this, okay, we'll take 3 porsi. Usually is good for garlic. Jadi untuk sup itu enak ya. Ini kacang wasabi. This is wasabi. Peanut. This tastes like wasabi. Apa ya? Daripada nggak ada, ini kacang bumbu. We bought this in Spetafore. Kita belinya di Spetafore. Around 65 ruble, 69, I forgot. Chicken panas. Panas.
Very fresh, seger. You can use champignon too, boleh pakai jamur kancing, cuma lebih enak yang ini. But for me, I prefer to use for soup is oyster mushroom. Yummy. Okay, I'm going to continue my eating because I want to watch something when I want to eat. Saya akan lanjut lah ya. Jadi sampai di sini dulu. Saya akan lanjut makan. Karena kalau saya makan itu biasanya harus ada bacaan atau TV. Okay, patah-patah.